He, Gil Scott Heron, he's an example, another great example of the creators of this art form that comes from African-American culture. You know, it's funny, right now the field in many ways is very crowded, and you know, the simple economics, supply and demand, if you have too much supply, it diminishes the demand. I think we're experiencing that right now because we have, in the United States alone, we have over 250 college level programs, so that's graduating classes of jazz majors every year. And when the field is that crowded, what happens is it's difficult to shine. And one of the ways that you shine in this art form historically is to be able to play with the legends, is to be able to stand on someone's shoulder. I got to play with Joe Henderson and Max Roach, and that's the way that I was able to stand out and shine a little bit. So people like Gil Scott Heron, I mean, they're just absolutely essential to the development of this art form, and they're essential in terms of making sure that the art form continues. The institution alone won't do it. You need a cultural foundation, and people like Gil Scott Heron are just a critical part of that.